students. So today we will start with the interfacing programs. So in this video I will explain you how to interface a DC motor to the logic circuit. So we will write a program to generate this circuit, and this circuit in turn control the DC motor. Okay, so our focus here to generate this circuit, a digital circuit has to be designed by writing the program. Okay, that is our task. So we will write a program to generate this digital circuit, which in turn control the DC motor. So with the DC motor, we are actually controlling the speed of the DC motor and also the direction of the DC motor. So there are two connections. You can see motor underscore direction, which is of 2 bits. Okay, 2 bits wire it is, and it controls the direction of the motor. Okay, and there is one line connection which is of motor speed, motor underscore speed, so which controls the speed of the motor. So these are the output of the logic circuit, and to the input, to we have on the input side we have a clock. So clock is, we are taking the clock from the board, and speed is dependent on this clock. Okay, I'll explain you how these two are dependent. And there is a one more input pin of DIR. It means the direction. When we give these, all these are 1 bit variables. Okay, 1 bit variables. Clock is also 1 bit. Speed is also 1 bit. When speed is high, logic high, it will rotate with one speed. When the speed is logic zero, it will rotate with the other speed. Okay, there are only 2 speeds: high speed and low speed. Similarly, when the direction is also of single bit variable. When the direction is logic 1, it will rotate in one direction. When this DIR pin is pulled to logic 0, then it will rotate in the other direction. Okay, so like that, these are the inputs and this is the output of the logic circuit, which will control the DC motor. Okay, now let's understand the concept behind how the direction of the motor is controlled. So this is the circuit, an explanation to, I'll make use of this circuit to explain how the DC motor direction is controlled. Okay, here is your DC motor, and I have marked the rotation of the motor. So when it is, I have 2 sources to indicate here. So when the motor direction, when the direction is logic 1, say for example, when the input direction is logic 1, the output of the logic circuit will be equal to 1 0. So when I give 1 0 to the motor direction, then it will be connected to this. So now you can see that the positive source is connected to one of the wire and the negative is connected to the other wire. So the current flows in this direction and the motor rotated in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay. Now when I change the input to logic 0, then the value of the motor direction will become 1 0 1, and this connection will move from here to here. Then as you can see that the source is connected to here, the positive of the source is connected to here and the negative is here, and the current flows in this direction and the motor rotated in the clockwise direction. So this is how we can understand easily that how the direction of the motor is controlled with this input. Okay, and this is the output of the motor, the logic circuit which will be applied to the DC motor. Clear? Next, how the speed of the motor is controlled. So speed of the motor, to control the speed of the motor, I'll take the help of the clock pulses. So here is the clock pulses which I'll obtain it from the board. So there is a crystal is there, so which supplies a high frequency clock pulse. So I'll use 2 variables called as high speed and low speed. Okay, and these 2 variables will keep the count of the clock pulse. Okay, and so I'll go on counting the clock pulse. For every positive edge of the clock pulse, I'll go on keeping the count high speed. So I'll go on counting the values of the clock pulses. So 1, 2, 3 and so on, I'll go on counting. Okay, and I'll apply a logic high value. I apply a logic high value when throughout the clock pulses. Okay, throughout the clock pulses, when I apply the logic high, it means that I am applying the power supply to the DC motor. So continuously I am applying, hence the speed of the motor is at high. Okay, the speed of the motor will be high speed. Okay, it will rotate continuously with high speed. Okay, now coming to the low speed here, what I do, I will not apply the logic high, that is in, the power is supplied discretely. So for certain clock period only I will apply, and after this clock periods, after the these many number of clock periods, what I will do is I will pull this to low. No, now I will not, I am not applying the power supply, and after the certain clock pulse again I will start applying, okay, and again after certain clock pulse I will pull it down. So this cycle repeats. So it means that I am applying the power supply discretely, okay, certain for a certain time period I will apply the source, and for certain clock pulses I will not apply. So this means the power source is not continuous, it is discrete. So by this I can control the speed of the motor. Okay, this is the logic I apply. This is same like your two-wheeler vehicle, where you, when you accelerate the motor, the accelerator continuously, then the motor will, the vehicle will move fast at a higher speed. But the same motor vehicle, when accelerated discretely, then the speed of the vehicle will be slow. So the same principle here also I am applying. So this is called as pulse width modulation, PWM. Okay, the width of the modulation of the wave will define the speed of the motor. Clear? So this is the concept what I am applying. So I will keep a count of these clock pulses using these variables, high speed and low speed. Okay. Now let's see how these concepts are used in the program. Okay. So I'll write a program now. So there is already, the program has been written. So you, I'll explain you how the, each of the variables play its role in the program. Okay. So my module name is DC motor. Okay. Every program we start with the module keyword, and the module name is DC motor. And here are the inputs. These are the inputs: clock, speed, and direction. Okay, and here are the outputs. Motor direction is 2 bit wide, so that's why it is 1 down to 0. And motor speed is of 1 bit, and so it is also of output. Okay, next. I require one more variable called as count, to count the number of clock pulses. So which is of 20 bits wide, so 19 down to 0, 20 bit wide. I have initialized the count as a register data type and I have made it immediately to 0. So count is 0 now initially. Now, so I require these high speed variables and low speed as variables as type wires. So these are intermediate connection between the gates. So these are the hanging wires. So that's why I declare them as wires. Okay. Now, so what is happening, you see here, always at pause edge of the clock. So every pause edge of the clock I'll keep the count. So count value will be go on incrementing. Okay, count equal to count plus 1. So this is happening at every pause edge of the clock pulse. So it is nothing but counting the clock pulses. Okay. So this is over. Always block is over now here. This always block is only for this statement. Next, assign motor speed. I am asking the motor speed now. What is the motor speed has to be applied? So here speed is the variable, whether it is logic high or logic zero. If the speed is logic high, then we are applying high speed. Okay, we are selecting the wire high speed. When the speed is logic low, then I am selecting low speed. This is the, this is an operator. It is an operator, it is called as conditional operator. I have explained this conditional operator, which has got two symbols, question mark and an is to symbol, used between two variables, three variables. Okay, three operands. So this conditional operator, which has got two symbols, used between two, between three operands. Okay, conditional operator we are using. So speed I am checking whether it is logic 1 or 0. 1 means I will select high speed, 0 means I will select low speed. Next, assign high speed. I will define now in the next two assignment statement, I will define what is high speed and what is low speed. So high speed, count, if the count is less than this value, means I have taken all the value. So in the program I have taken complete value. This is 5 F's are there. 5 F means each of 4 bits. So 4 5's are 20 bit value. It is a 20 bit value. As I am applying for high speed, I will apply the voltage, that is logic 1, for continuously up to this value. Means I am asking, count is less than this value? Yes, because so we are starting with 0, so obviously the wherever you take the value of the count, it will be always less than this value. Agreed? So always it will be less than this value
hence it will be logic high only. Okay, if at all this is this goes, this value goes to greater than this, then only it will be zero. Okay, as there is no provision here in this case to zero, sometimes it will be made as E. So last bit we will make it to logic one, but still it will not make much difference. Okay, next, for low speed, assign low speed. What I am doing, if count goes less than this value, up to here 4FFFF, up to here it will be logic one. So I am supplying the current. Okay, after this 4, that is 5000, then I will apply 0. From 500 to FFF, it will be logic 0. Logic 0. So here it is. I am asking whether the count is this much valid. If the count is less than this value, it will be logic 1. If the count crosses this value, it will be logic 0. Okay. And it will be like this waveform. Okay, discrete. For certain period of time it will be on, and for certain period of time it will be off. Okay, I am accelerating discretely. That is the meaning of it. Next, I have defined high speed and low speed. Now it is the time of direction. Again, assignment statement, motor direction, output of the logic circuit. I am asking input to the logic circuit, whether it is 1 or 0. Logic 1, then I will apply 0-1. 0-1 means in one direction. Maybe assume that it is clockwise direction. Next, if the direction is logic 0, then I will apply 1-0. So it will be in the other direction. Okay. So this is how I define the direction of the motor. And this is how I define the whether it will rotate in high speed or low speed. And here I have defined what is low speed and high speed, making use of the counts. Clear? So four assignment statements will define the speed and direction of the motor. Okay. Thank you. Pause it.
Okay, these are the three icons which should be there in order to program the Verilog program onto the kit. Okay, and for synthesis also, these are the three icons should be there on your desktop. Okay, so first we will open the ISC. This is the Xilinx ISC design suite of 13.1 version. So which is used, we will use to program this Spartan 6 kit. So a window will be open like this. You just say OK, and some Suraj name project is already running. So what I'll do is I'll show you this demonstration will be for okay. This demonstration will be for how to open a project and continue with the source file adding, and then how to synthesis and how to synthesis and simulate it. Okay, all that once. So first go to file, say new project. So new project, what I'll do is I'll give you give the name as KSIT. You have to give your name. So here there is a provision to select the path also. So what I'll do is I'll select the path as E. I'll be selecting the folder E folder. Okay, so KSIT is my project name and I am storing at E folder. Say next. Okay, and these are the selections which you have to make. Family of the family has to be selected as Spartan 6. This is what is there in our lab, Spartan 6 kit. And device serial number is XC6SLX4. Package is of TQG 144. This is the Spartan 6 kit, and this is the FPGA board of with the serial with the device name as XC6SLX4, and quadrature package means on all the four sides it is packaged with 144 pins. Okay, and XST is the synthesis tool what we use, and iSIM is the simulator, and the preferred language of programming is Verilog. So these are the selections which you have to make for the project, and say next. So this is where you will see that all the selections what we have made here, all these are displayed here. And after that you verify here and finish. Okay, project name will be created here. Just a minute.
pause my day. So now we are, the project is created in the name of KSIT, this where you can see here, and these are the properties what we have selected. You can verify here in the design properties, you can verify the selections what we have made. Next photo, okay. Save, okay. So now we have to add the source file. So here you can right click and add a new source file. This is the one way of doing it, or else you go to the project and say new source file. Okay, when you create click the new source file, here it will ask for which of the module. So you have to say Verilog module, as we are doing Verilog programming. And the file name here, this file name keeps on changing, whereas the project name remains the same. So here file name is, what we are doing is DC motor. So what I will do is, I will create a file with the name DC motor. Here also I can select the path. So where I want to store that. So as I have created in the E folder, my project. So there only I will store this my file name also. So this file name keeps on changing, whereas your project name remains the same throughout the semester. So say next. Here if at all you know the input, you can add it here. Okay. If at all you don't know the number of inputs and number of outputs, then you can neglect it. I'm just, for the demonstration, I'm showing A and B as A being the input and B being the output. So here this is the module gets created with the name DC motor, and a respective file also gets added here. Okay. Now, as I have already edited the program, now you can edit the program here of the DC motor. So here I have already created, just I will copy that file now. Okay. So it is in the folder C users source. Okay, this is the program which I have already created, so just I'll copy it and I'll remove this. This is our actual program. Now I'll add the program here. Okay, the same program what I explained on the board, same program I have used here. Okay, same count, motor direction, motor speed. So motor speed, I am asking whether it is high speed or low speed. I have defined high speed and low speed, and motor direction also. So now after editing the program, now you have to save it. So save the project. Now implementation, just check the synthesis. Check for syntax error, if at all it any error. So no error, then you have to go for IO pin planning. So when you go for IO pin planning post synthesis, a window will open like this. You have to close the upper window, and this is where the banks of ports are there, and you need to select appropriate ports when you are interfacing. So you have to select appropriate ports. So the port list is given here on your board here. So for DC motor it is given here, for the LCD pin it is given here, for ADC it is given here. So for DAC interfacing we have given here. So according to that you can use it. This is for reference, you can use it. As you can see that 82 and 83 are there. So those pin I'll select, and clock is by default it is 56. I'll select that clock also. So if I'll start with the clock, so 56 is my clock. Okay. And now 82 and 83 are the values. 82 is DIR 0, DIR 1, and 84 is my motor speed. Okay, next, input pins I have to select. Input pins are here from 121, 123 and 121 and 123 I will select. So 121 is my, let it be direction, and 123 is my speed control. Okay, so speed control and direction are the input. Clock is also an input. So I have selected all with respect to the ports. Save it. Next, go for implement design. Next, generate program file. So this generate program file will create the bit file required to be burned onto the kit, okay, or transfer that bit file onto the kit. So we are burning that bit file onto the kit. So how it is done? So we require one more icon here, VSF6 2.0. So this is the icon, or this is a small software which helps us to transfer the bit file from the system onto the board. So for that, first I have to connect the board. So USB B type is the connector, so that I have to connect. So open it. There are two options we have to select: file name and the COM port. So every COM port differs from system to system. So that information you can fetch it from here, from the My Computer. So right click on the My Computer, go to Manage, select Device Manager, and click on the ports. So here is that VFPGA 6 Spartan 6 kit connected to COM25. So this COM25 differs from system to system. So every system has got their own COM port. So you have to select that particular COM port. So I'll repeat once again this procedure. So go to My Computer, right click, Manage, Device Manager, Ports. So here is the COM port, okay, Spartan 6 kit COM is connected to COM25. So you have to select COM port number 25 here, as this is the case in our system, and the file name. File name will be in the format. So KS8 is my project. When you go to that particular project, here is the bit file which gets generated. DC motor is my module name. The bit file gets generated in the name of the module. So I have selected the bit file and also the COM port. So now I'll configure. When I say configure, the bit file gets transferred onto the kit. So as you can see, when I configure, the bit file is getting transferred and a blue LED light will be glowing. So it means that the data is coming into the kit. Okay, now I will connect the DC motor here. This is the driver IC which is there to drive the motor. Now I'll make the connection here. So as soon as I make the connection, the motor starts rotating, because already the current the connections are already made. So now the motor is rotating with certain speed. So when I reduce it, when it is logic zero, it will rotate in with low speed. So it is in the anti-clockwise direction. So when I make logic one, then it will rotate in the high speed. Okay. Now I'll bring it to low speed. Now I'll change the direction of the motor. So as you can see that the direction of the motor got changed. Okay, now it is rotating in the clockwise direction. Okay. Now here also I can make the change of speed. Okay. And speed getting changed. Direction of the motor getting changed. Here also the speed getting changed. Low speed, direction,